Alternative medicines have a lot of problems, but there's a big one we haven't talked about.
Okay, Bill, before we get going here, I want to thank you for proving my point I made about you in a previous video, that you are a phony piece of shit and an attention whore, and that the only thing you're interested in is saving your own career. From a comedian to the science guy, and let's not forget that degree you have in mechanical engineering. Now you have morphed into an ethno-masochistic cuck for social justice. Bill Nye saves his career by any means. No dignity required.
I'll let Prashant Venkat, one of our writers on the show, explain. Prashant?
Thank you, Bill. Now, I know what you're thinking. Indian guy might be into alt medicines and stuff, but I actually hate them. I especially hate how they're marketed. Remember sound therapy guy David Gibson? Did you happen to notice these little gems peppered around his place? Why are there three random Buddhas and an Om symbol?
Because he's a spiritualist and he's influenced by the Dalai Lama, who happens to be a Buddhist. And it makes perfect sense, being a sound therapist, because there's many sounds to Buddhism that's therapeutic, and we'll talk about that in a minute. But really, Guy, if you were that curious, all you had to do was type in a Google search, David Gibson sound therapist. You have to put in sound therapist because there's a couple of David Gibsons out there. And you would have came across the very same interview that I came across if David Gibson would have answered all your questions. Then again, it's damn the facts with people like you. You're not interested in the facts. This whole thing about alternative medicine is just a thin veil to the lecture about cultural appropriation that's coming. Oh, and by the way, I love the way you say alt medicine in relation to the alt-right. And you made sure that you said you hate alt medicine just like you hate the alt-right. Great psychology. The screams of cultural appropriation reach fever pitch on Halloween, when people dress up in those cultural outfits. Imitation being the highest form of flattery is being replaced by cultural appropriation. Yeah, I heard this from Francesca Ramsey last Halloween. Yeah, you know Francesca Ramsey from MTV Decoded? You know, the black girl that straightens her hair like white women do? And I don't see Japan shutting down their baseball league anytime soon. Nor do I hear from blacks and other minorities announcing that they're going to be getting out of baseball because it's a white man's sport, invented by white men. And since we're on the subject of team sports, with the exception of soccer, football, basketball, and hockey, we're all invented by white people. You can't play those games under the guidelines of cultural appropriation. Cultural appropriation will eventually regress us back to segregation and a tribal-like mentality, which flies in the face of the melting pot, multiculturalism, globalism, diversification, one world government, or any other kind of cohesive, productive society you're trying to create.
Sound therapy has nothing to do with Buddhism or Hinduism.
Actually, Buddhism has everything to do with sound therapy. You have drums, you have bells, you have the Om, all designed to put you in a specific state of mind. I mean, aren't you a Buddhist? Or are you a Muslim? Because in Islam, there's only one therapeutic sound. Boom!
This happens a lot, so I'm just going to come out and say it. White people, I love you.
No, correction. Your love for white people only applies to ethno-masochistics as your fuck buddy Bill Nye, who is the lowest form of life a single slab of DNA can produce.
But stop using Asian wallpaper for street cred. I see what you're doing, and it's stupid.
No! People can do whatever they want with Asian wallpaper. Hell, I'm thinking of wrapping my cock and balls in Asian wallpaper, take a selfie, and email it to you and your fuck buddy Bill Nye. You still love me?
Look, I get it, white people. It's hard selling incense without weed. So you say it's magic and that it cures gout, and for good measure you throw in a Ganesh statue just to give it this ancient wisdom-y feel. Suddenly business is booming. It's actually the oldest trick in the book. Half nonsense, half Indian. It's called the Deepak Chopra.
Excuse me. but you just appropriated a word derived from the Latin incinder, meaning to burn. Incense can be traced back 3000 BCE. The Chinese started using it around 2000 BCE. Others will tell you the burning of incense goes back to the advent of fire. Seems like just about every culture out there, still existing and non-existing, had at one time or another used incense. So no one culture can really lay claim to the burning of incense. It's basically used in religious rituals. Pagans use it to remove any negative energy. Maybe we should burn a ton of incense around you and Bill Nye and see if removing the negative energy really works. Oh, and by the way, after a couple of bong tokes, I usually spray my room with Febreze. Lavender scent.
Then again, it's not entirely your fault, white people. Which is why I want to say something to my fellow Asians. Asians, lend me your ears. Stop convincing white people it is real. This is as much on you as it is on them. You know how gullible they are. You know they just want to fit in. Look, I know. We all had a lot of fun watching white people get Chinese tramp stamps throughout the 2000s. But this is different. When they see Asians doing Reiki to cure cancer or South Asians marrying people based on astrology, they see truth and they want to copy us. And that's when it gets really dangerous. But more importantly, that's when it gets really tacky.
What was that you said about loving white people, you dishonest piece of sacred cow dung? If a white person came up and started telling half-assed jokes about black people, I have no doubt Netflix would never allow this show to air. Or should I say stream? Yeah, we are all having a hell of a time catching up with technology, at least when it comes to words. Really, people are still referring to video recordings as film. It's not film anymore.
I mean, look what they've done to yoga. Yoga was badass. Yoga is actually good for you, but white people got their Lululemon hands on it and turned it into the smooth jazz of the fitness world.
Don't forget, he loves white people. Yeah, and look at all these happy white folks in the audience. They are either self-loathing ethno-masochists as Bill Nye, or the producer is paying them to laugh. It's one or the other. Unfortunately, it's likely the former rather than the latter. I know you'd have to pay me good money just to sit there without jumping out of my chair and going for Bill Nye's throat. But I do notice a couple in the audience who do not seem to be amused. A lot of people who grew up with Bill Nye the Science Guy in the 90s are gravely disappointed with Bill Nye's product of today. People wanted a revamping of the Science Guy and they didn't get it. They got a couple of science segments in between all the social justice bullshit. And I refuse to play that horrible, song about gender fucking identity. And speaking of gender identity...
Can't we just come to a ceasefire? Asians, stop selling unregulated remedies with no scientific basis. And white people, stop using Asian culture to sell unregulated remedies with no scientific proof. Let's just get back to the good old days. Put the Ganesh statue into storage and just go back to telling me how much you love samosas.
But what about the gender spectrum Bill Nye shoved in everybody's faces? The concept of more than two genders with no scientific proof. And I'm sure there are a few Asians out there not too happy with this humorless pile of fecal matter lecturing to them as well as to white folks. I never watched Bill Nye's original show, The Science Guy. My exposure to Bill Nye at that time was when he went on shows which I watched to be interviewed. But I'll tell you exactly when I lost all respect for Bill Nye. When he did that stupid-ass debate with Ken Ham. All he accomplished there was allowing Ken Ham to raise money to finish his stupid arc for his creationist museum. The audience he spoke to, their minds were fixed in stone. So the only thing Bill Nye did was enable stupidity. The only reason he did that debate was to get his face in front of the camera. Because he's an attention whore and he's trying to save a floundering career. Refusing to accept the fact that he, Bill Nye, is a has-been. Instead, he checked his dignity at the door, flushed real science down the toilet, and bowed before the golden altar of social justice and bullshit pseudoscience. Congratulations, Bill, you piece of shit. Anyway, that's about it for now. I want to thank you all for stopping by and for tuning in. And until we talk again, I want you all to be well and enjoy life.